الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us to be in the masjid. This is, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most beloved places on earth to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the masjid. So if you need anything, come to the masjid. Make wudu, pray to rak'ah, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this amazing, wallahi amazing hadith. He says, whoever make wudu in the house and go to the masjid, just for Salah Maktouba, just for Maghrib, Isha, any prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them that and the reward of Hajj. Hajj cost more than $10,000. I don't know if any of us save $10,000 a year. Half an hour maximum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and he, you go to the masjid just to learn something good or to teach something good. Same reward. Hajj, and the Prophet ﷺ said, it is tam. It's a perfect Hajj. Not just the Hajj that you don't know. You ask the Shaykh, I said, I did this mistake. No, no. The Prophet ﷺ said tam. So that's what we hear. We come to get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to invest in our life in Jannah. And we talk about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger, the best of mankind, the most noble human being. I can't even imagine the blessing Allah gave to us to be from his followers sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And last time we finished talking about Badr, yes, talked a lot. We finished talking about Uhud. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Muslim, they left everything. To the pagan, they left everything, their home, their land, their farm, their animal, their money, their gold, everything. And some of them sneaked out with just the clothes in their back secretly, walk even. Ali ibn Abi Talib walk from Mecca to Medina just to be able to establish a community, a masjid like this to pray. And guess what? The pagan followed them, yeah? Tried to attack them, tried to incite the other tribes to attack them. And Allah gave huge victory in Badr. And then they came back again the third year in Uhud. 3,000, three more times than the first time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and, you know, the Umar, Abu Bakr, and the big companions' name. Now, they started to cause war from the inside. Medina had Muslim, yeah, made from Ansar, the people of Medina. And there is other groups in Medina. There's three other groups, very rich, very powerful. They even build their own compound, their own fortresses to separate from the Muslim. A Muslim, the roof of the masjid, if it rains, is muddy. The fortress of the rich other groups, you can't even penetrate. So the pagan started to, they don't need incitement. They're already jealous of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when the Battle of Uhud happened, they helped. From inside Medina, they helped the pagan. They said, here is your Muslim, here you stand, here you sit, here you get the water, here you get the food. So the Prophet ﷺ went and he said, we have an agreement. This is our city together. We live in it together. It's a very small. It's actually 1 square kilometer. Yeah? It's not big. You can't do this. You can't help anybody against us or we help anybody against you. Please. They said, Muhammad, oh, you haven't fought man yet. You haven't seen war yet. You wait till you face us. Straight away like this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of course, he's the best of manners. He doesn't speak like that, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, we have an agreement. We have a deal. So what happened is, I told you the story. They attacked a Muslim woman. Yeah, and it was very ugly, very bad. And when the man Muslim go to defend, they killed the man. That's it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that's it. They cannot be our neighbors. You can't trust him for the woman. He killed the man that defends her. What did he do? Leave us. Just leave Medina, go and live somewhere else. Just, yeah, leave. We can defend it. You just leave. Take whatever you want. Take your stuff. Just leave us. That's, subhanAllah. No bombing, no killing, no cutting. No, just leave us alone. When they left, this is Banu Qaynuqa. Yeah? First one. Obviously, now the Prophet ﷺ have more enemies, not Quraysh, this also. Then when Uhud came and they helped in Uhud, the Prophet ﷺ had another tribe. It's called Banu Nadir. Banu Nadir, they made worse. They tried to kill the Prophet ﷺ himself. Yeah? They planned to assassinate the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ himself. You know, this also is very difficult to even imagine the reaction. You know, if we are, wallahi, if, you know, if somebody tells us he's going to kill the Prophet, what we're going to do? We just cut them to pieces. Yeah? We do not, no talking anymore. No, the Prophet ﷺ talked to them and said to them, take whatever your camels can carry, but just leave. Just leave Medina. I can't trust you. So they left. Now they have more enemies to Islam. They went to Khaybar. We all hear about it. Khaybar is bigger than Medina. More richer, more powerful, more fortress. And now they're coward. They can't fight. Yeah? But they have the money, they have the weapons, they can. Yeah. So what they did, they went straight to Mecca and said to them, what happened to you? Why are you not attacking the Muslim anymore? It's been a year without attack. They said, we tried twice, three times, four times. It's not working. They're very fearless, coward, you know, brave. And we can't. You know, we tried. We can't do it. What about we pay everything? We're going to give you the money. We're going to buy the horses, buy the armors. We're actually going to give more army with you. Yeah? So you come from the south. We bring some more from the north. We have criminal gangs called Ghatafan, we're going to pay them. Abu Sufyan says, this is good. Somebody's paying for it. Yeah, it's good. Not only that, they don't know how to fight. So Abu Sufyan will become the king. Abu Sufyan, you lead. Here is the gold and here is the money. And you come and we follow you. We're going to give half the produce of the whole farm to the army. SubhanAllah, this is, you can't, if you're criminal like this, you can't refuse this offer. He says, if I come, I'm the boss, yeah, no problem. We come to attack Medina, but I need a week or two to get all the tribes to come. Yeah, we need a week or two. They went north. Ghatafan is 2,000 thugs, criminal, no morals, no value, nothing. They just come to fight for the sake of fighting. Yeah, they're not enemies or anything. You know, they come to steal. That's what it is. So the Jews also went up and brought Ghatafan and said to them, we're going to everything, once we kill all the Muslims, you take half the produce, half the land for you. The Prophet heard about this. And now the Muslim is what? 1,000 maximum 1,000 men, maximum. With women and children is about 2,500. So the Prophet ﷺ said, I think we're going to be attacked by 10,000. This have never happened in history. The Arab, till that time, the tribes, 200, 300, 400, they're fighting each other all the time. Now, for the first time in the history books, they united, all of them, united against the Prophet ﷺ, against Islam. For the first time. Two flags only, Islam and Kufr. SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's what Allah is saying. Allah wanted to really show the truth from the falsehood. Because no matter what idols you have, they're all the same. They're united. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he normally does, he consulted the Sahaba. He convened them in the masjid and he said, what do you think? 10,000, now it's four times more than the population. And the criminals coming, not noblemen. There's no way to defend yourself. It's really, you know, we have to fight. You know, you have to fight to the death. But this where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always comes with His support, comes with His plan, comes with miracles. And the miracle was one man. One man. His name is Salman. Salman the Persian, Salman al-Pharisee. For the first, Salman did not come to Uhud, did not come to Badr. Salman was a slave with the Yahud in Khaybar. He was betrayed. This is a very long story, inshallah, I'll tell you about him. He was betrayed and kidnapped and sold as a slave. He's working as a slave and he wanted to become Muslim. The owner of the farm said to him, you have to plant 300 trees. You have to pay me 40 ounces of gold. It's like, he can't leave you. He went to the Muslim helped him out. He was only free maybe weeks before this time. So Salman from the Persian Empire, forget the Arab, this is the 700 years of fighting. They conquered the Roman Empire. They were so powerful in military might. So the Prophet is consulting them, and Salman says, Messenger of Allah, in the Persian Empire, إِذَا حُصِرْنَا خَنْدَقْنَا. When we are surrounded with big numbers, we dig a trench between us and them. It's easy to defend the trench, because by the time you go down, a rock will kill you, an arrow will kill you. But if you leave it like that, there's no way to defend. They will wipe us out. Digging a trench. The Arab have never heard of a trench, they never used it, never know what it is. The Prophet ﷺ was kind of amazed at the idea. Yes, obviously, great idea. Divided the Sahaba, the 1,000, divide this stretch of 2.5 kilometers, you got 2 weeks only. Every group, 10 at a time, dig. Have to dig it wide enough, deep enough, that the horses can jump over and nobody can go down and cross it. And we will guard it from one side. 2 weeks, 24/7, digging. SubhanAllah. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself carrying the dirt. Carrying the, SubhanAllah, Allah, SubhanAllah. SubhanAllah. We say to the brothers, come to the masjid to help, not carry dirt. And they look at the watch, oops, busy brothers, very busy. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that, can you imagine? The prophets before him, they make him leader. And the day of judgment, the 300 billion human being will be calling him, Ana Sayyid Walad Adam Wala Fakhr. The best of mankind, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is not bragging. It is Allah's choice, it's Allah's creation. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was carrying dirt and rocks and chanting with them. اللهم لولا أنت ما اهتدينا ولا تصدقنا ولا صلينا فأنزل سكينة علينا وثبت الأقدام إن لاقينا. Translation tomorrow, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion in Jannah. جزاكم الله خير.